Good morning, I'm Juan Perez, Senior Foreign Exchange Trader and Strategist here at Tempest. Thank you so much for watching our weekly videos. As I warned you last week was not only going to be a short week, but there really wasn't a whole lot of impacting information. However, the US dollar did improve by about a percent against its 10 major currencies, according to the Bloomberg Dollar Spot Index, which is a good sign, right? The US dollar has been swimming in some very dangerous waters. Ever since the beginning of the year, it looked like the bets on the dollar going down only increased. And the reasons for that, we'll get into them, because this upcoming week, we're actually gonna have plenty of data and plenty of events that are going to perhaps help the dollar turn the tide that's been against it. Last week though, we need to recognize that the pound finally went down. It went down finally by close to 1%. The reason behind it, Brexit concerns, but also finally economics concerns. The gross domestic product actually did not meet expectations. The Q4 of 2017 was definitely a slow one for the United Kingdom, with growth of only 0.4%. Of course, the 0.5% that was expected didn't even come up. At the end of this week, we'll have a speech by Theresa May. The Prime Minister is gonna speak about Brexit. We're gonna see if there is an actual strategy and there's more clarity and vision. I certainly don't believe it's going to happen. We'll see if there are any surprises. But Friday will be a major day, and the swings for pound will continue to go up and down, as always. The euro lost almost 1% against the dollar as well. Really, there was nothing throughout the week that gave any indication of a slowdown economically in Europe, but Europe has to worry about its political situation. The German coalition building that we've been mentioning tons of times, that seems to be finally reaching a stage where the Social Democrats will actually sign something that will align them officially with Merkel's Christian Democratic Party. We'll see how Germany deals with that situation, because Italian elections are coming up on March 4th. Berlusconi, the former very controversial leader, who's a media tycoon, may have his party make a major comeback, or we could have more alternative parties such as the Five Star Movement, which is a combination of leftist environmentalism and anti-European, anti-establishment feeling. They could take over. So there's a lot of uncertainty about where Italy is going to go. And the Canadian dollar did fall by 1.5% last week. NAFTA talks are going to be revamped this week, but more importantly, retail sales in Canada were expected to have a little bit of expansion or no expansion. They contracted dramatically, almost by 1% last week, which gives a few signs of a slowdown as well to our North American neighbor. So we'll see what happens with the dollar. We have a major testimony by Jerome Powell, the new Federal Reserve head, tomorrow to a House panel in Congress, and really we're going to speak about where, we're going to see what he says and what his vision of America's economy is, and if there is really any divergence from where Janet Yellen had us on a path towards tightening. Again, thank you so much for watching these videos. If you have any questions, comments, let us know. And I will also say, if you're a client of ours, definitely read the Tempest Yearly Outlook for 2018. It's starting to look not like Nostradamus or anything too exciting, but we are being as accurate as we can. Thank you so much for watching.